You're listening to the Spark Radio Network, internet radio like you've never heard before. Innovation, creativity, and imagination are all said to begin with a spark. So fasten your seatbelt and take the ride of your life and listen for the spark.
In these uncertain economic times, you've got to do whatever you can to save money. One of our biggest expenses can be our cars, especially when unexpected repair bills hit. Not anymore. If you own a vehicle with less than 130,000 miles, is less than 12 years old, has a warranty about to expire, or even no warranty at all, you could stop paying for car repairs. Roadside assistance, towing, and rental coverage are all included. Don't wait for the next repair. Make one free call right now to see if you qualify. If you're vehicle is less than 12 years old, has less than 130,000 miles, even if it's out of warranty, paying for car repairs can become a thing of the past. Call us right now and get your car protected before your next repair bill hits. Get protection and no more repair bills. Call 800-696-1030. Again, 800-696-1030. That's 800-696-1030. 800-696-1030.
Joe had huge problems with the IRS.
I knew it was coming. I hadn't filed taxes since 1990.
All the IRS letters coming in added up to a nightmare.
To get up to like $68,000, my heart started beating fast. It's like, there's no way, man. I mean, I ain't going to be able to do this.
Then they stopped his paycheck.
So that's when I started making phone calls and found U.S. Tax Shield.
U.S. Tax Shield went to work immediately.
They just took the bull by the horns. What blew my mind is he called the IRS right then and there.
So why is U.S. Tax Shield A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau? Joe knows.
They saved me a ridiculous amount of money.
If you owe more than $10,000 to the IRS or state, choose the company Joe chose, U.S. Tax Shield.
It was the best decision I made. U.S. Tax Shield is the way to go. Life is good. Thank you, Lord.
Call 800-471-3287.
U.S. Tax Shield. Boo-rah. Yes.
800-471-3287. 800-471-3287.
Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the Internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? America Off the Rails has been declared a conservatives-only safe zone. Only conservatives allowed from this point forward. Any liberal, socialist, butthurt, hippie, tree huggers, please exit the facility immediately. Again, attention, please. America Off the Rails is now designated as a conservative safe zone only. All butthurt, tree hugging, hippie, freedom, you and me types, exit the facility immediately. Thank you.
Folks, you are listening to America Off the Rails, now a proud member of the Conservative Commando Radio Network, right here on WNJC 1360 AM, the powerhouse of Philadelphia. Now, I have a question for you. Do you ever find yourself maybe not near a radio? Maybe you're traveling and you don't have access to the internet? Did you know that the Conservatives Commando Radio Network can now be heard on a telephone network by calling 832-999-1199 anytime, day or night? That's right. You can hear every show as it's broadcast live, even if you're not near the radio or an internet, because, you know, everybody nowadays has a phone in their hand. But here's the good news, though. As soon as we go off the air at night on the Conservative Commando Radio Network right here on WNJC, you can listen to every show that aired for that day as many times as you want just by dialing that number. It'll be a live feature every day at 12 p.m. daily, and it'll be exclusively for the shows that run on that network. But until the next day when it goes live again, they're going to run them over and over and over again. So now you have on-demand access to the Conservative Commando Radio Network right on your phone. How cool is that? Just remember, the Conservative Commando Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
We will keep this promise to the American people. If you like your doctor, you will be able to keep your doctor, period. If you like your health care plan, you'll be able to keep your health care plan, period.
This is the most transparent administration in history. Not even a smidgen of corruption.
Fact is, we had four dead Americans. What difference at this point does it make?
If you got a business, you didn't build that.
Welcome to the face. Welcome to the face.
Keep on doing what you do, Rick. You're my favorite host, favorite host, favorite host.
It's time to hear the truth about America's biggest challenges. You're listening to America Off the Rails with your host, Rick Robinson.
Well, good afternoon, Philadelphia. This is Rick Robinson. You are listening to America Off the Rails. I know we've started it this way before, but in this instance, I think it's actually more true than it was the last time I did it. So let's go ahead. Yeah, that's right, Mr. Producer. Go ahead and crank that on up. Come on, folks. Sing it with me.
The end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. The GOP's dead.
All right, so forgive my singing moment there, but I'm sorry, it's been a rough week. And this election cycle isn't getting any better. Speaking of which, if you're not following me on Twitter, you probably should be. It would have been kind of entertaining. Today, if we could translate the Twitter typing into sound, this is about what my Twitter timeline has looked like all day today. Because, you know, I keep telling everybody, hey, you know, I'm not going to vote for Trump. I can't do it, won't do it. So I keep getting this, and then occasionally somebody will kind of throw in one of these.
You suck!
And, you know, it's just been fun all day. Which, look, I'm not telling any of you what it is that I think you should do. I'm telling you what I'm not going to do. But anytime I start trying to give you guys my opinion as to why I won't vote for Trump, a lot of you sound a lot like this guy.
My God, are you still talking?
And all I'm saying is I'm not telling you who to vote for, what you should do, when you should do it, how you should do it, or who you should do it with. What I'm telling you is the reasons why I cannot vote for Trump. I'm not telling you to violate your principles. I don't even care if you do violate your principles. There are plenty of people that I know that follow the same mantra over and over and over again. Whoever the nominee is has to get the vote. Whoever the nominee is has to get the vote. Whoever the nominee is has to get the vote. Whoever the nominee is has to get the vote. Whoever the nominee is has to get the vote. Okay, sounds great, really? But we've done that. How many years now? Is that working for us? Come on, look. I was with you with McCain. I held my nose. I pulled the lever. I was with you with Romney. I held my nose. I pulled the lever, and I was the one during the 2012 election cycle telling everybody, "Look, we have to go with the nominee. We have to do it. It's what's best for the country." The problem is, we don't have a nominee yet. But everybody, including the frontrunner, is acting like it's a foregone conclusion. So much so that he has now decided he's not doing any more debates. Look, can I just say something? And I said this on Twitter, but I'm going to say it here now. When you decide that you're going to run for president, there are certain things that the American public expects from you. You are to make sure that your financials are readily available so that folks can review them. And you are expected to show up for the debates. Here's the thing that I'm going to tell every single one of you. If you don't like the fact that so far we've had, what, 11, 12 debates, then maybe we should start making sure we don't start out the field with 17 candidates. Because when you start out the field with 17 candidates who are all out for themselves, then you are going to have a lot of debates to winnow out the field. We have just now finally gotten to a three-person race, which in all estimation and honesty should be a two-person race. But Kasich has decided he's in it for the long haul regardless, and we'll actually talk about him a little bit later because I have some unique footage of what he does when he's not on the campaign trail that we'll be talking about here in just a little bit. But that being said, this should be, at this point, a two-person race. Kasich's going to decide that he's going to be the third wheel. Okay, so be it. But here's the point. We are now finally getting to the point where the American people and the American public can hear what these candidates actually plan on doing. Not read it on a website, but actually watch them, gauge their reactions, and see what they say. You can learn a lot by reading someone's website. I'm not going to lie. But you can learn a lot more by watching them when they tell you things. And now let me tell you what this tells me. This tells me one of two things. Either Donald Trump, well, I can't say that word on the air. Either Donald Trump is a big chicken and he's afraid of Megyn Kelly, or he knows now that the only two people that really anybody's going to be paying attention to are going to be Cruz and Trump, that he doesn't stand a chance. Look. It's a foregone conclusion at this point with Kasich in the race. He's going to steal enough electorates from both of them that neither one of them is going to get to the magic number. The 12, what is it, 1270s? I don't have it in front of me right now. But anyway, the magic number, nobody's going to get there. And that's what Kasich wants to do by design. Now, we had been talking about a brokered convention if things stayed broken enough where Rubio stayed in it, Carson stayed in it, and then even Kasich stayed in it. But now that we're down to three people, we're probably looking at more of what is considered a contested convention. A contested division, a convention is not the big bad one that everybody's been talking about where the Republican big bosses are sitting in a smoke-filled room drawing lots and taking bets and doing whatever they got to do to get inside favors to make sure that their guy gets the nod. This is still done through the electorate. Basically, the delegates are still the ones that make the decision in the in the contested convention. Sorry, folks. Been fighting this cough thing, and no matter what I do, it seems like right before I go on the air, no matter what I do, it gets worse. Maybe it's because I spend all day every day talking way too much. Go figure. All right, but anyway, so where were we? Contested convention. Pretty simple concept. Basically, if nobody gets to the magic number, the delegates have to sit down and hash out to figure out where their votes are going to go. So it's not as bad as the other one, but it's still not a good thing. Here's my thing, because I'm not telling anybody who to vote for. I'm just telling you why I can't vote for him and why I won't vote for him. I've said it over and over again. I'm not going to keep repeating myself. It's pinned on my Twitter. My very top tweet on there says, I'm never Trump, and this is why, so listen to my show if you want to find out, because I'm done talking about it. I've outlined it over and over and over again, and at this point, it doesn't matter anymore. What I want to have happen at this point is for Kasich to say, okay, look, I tried it, I did my best, I'm done. Get it down to the two front runners and let them go toe-to-toe and let America decide. Look, whoever America decides, great. If it's Trump, I'll figure out a way to get through it. If it's Cruz, then we've got a really good shot at beating Hillary. Yeah, I said it that way on purpose. I'm telling you, folks, if Trump is the one that gets the nomination, the mainstream media is going to eat him alive. And I've outlined that over and over and over again. Look, there are so many stories that are just now starting to come out about Donald Trump. And for some reason, now he suddenly has Anonymous mad at him. And apparently they're going to start trying to go after him. But, you know, what do I know? I'm just a talk show host. I actually spent half the afternoon today arguing with a guy on Twitter who shall remain nameless, who basically told me that I should set up a debate between him, Mr. Nobody, and Cruz, and that he would own Cruz in the debate. I'm like, look, I'm a talk show host. It's not like I have a bad phone to the candidates and can be like, hey, this jackass that I've only been talking to for like 30 seconds, yeah, he wants to debate you. And he wants it to be no holds barred, no rules, no moderator, just you two. Mano a mano, to the death of words, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, because I really have that kind of pull with the presidential candidates. I mean, look, I've talked to some big name folks. I mean, I've had some folks on my show that are important. I'm not going to toot my own horn about it. But those of you that have been listening for a while, you've heard some of the interviews that we've done. Some of them that I've gone after, I haven't gotten yet. But we are getting bigger. Especially now here that we're, thanks to being on WNJC, we are getting a lot more noticed. So that is definitely a lovely thing. But at the same time, even if I had that type of access, let's say for the sake of argument that, you know, I could be like, hey, Cruz, I'm going to be up in D.C. Let's get together, have a beer, we'll have a few laughs, get together. It'll be fun. Yeah, let's pretend for a moment that I had that kind of access. Just for the sake of argument. Let's pretend I had that kind of access. If I did that, do you really think I'd be like, hey, I've got this completely unknown jabroni over here who says that not only will he debate you, but he could own you. And I think you should do it. Yeah, look, okay, so even if I had that kind of pull, I wouldn't after that moment. Just for the record. Because after the debate, Cruz would be talking to me like this.
You suck!
That's right.
You suck!
Over and over and over again. I'd call him, and it'd be like one of those things where, you know, you have the phones now, a lot of them, you can like program it to where it gives like specific messages based on who's calling. I'd call his number.
You suck!
That'd be all I'd hear. It'd be fun. Not really. But, you know, I mean, back to this guy. It's all I kept hearing about all day today is how, you know, Cruz's establishment, Cruz is for white genocide, and the fact that I'm supporting Cruz makes me support white genocide. You know, the interesting thing about the folks that throw around the words white genocide, they usually spend their spare time in pillowcases. Just saying. He didn't like the fact that I pointed that out either. But so, yeah, that was kind of the extent of my day on Twitter. I've been basically lambasted and accosted by Trumpkins. Not going to lie, I gave as good as I got in a lot of cases. So I'm not an innocent party and I'm not crying victim. I'm just saying it's been an interesting day on Twitter. Because the thing about it is, he's got about half the delegates that he needs right now. And as far as the entire bloomin' Trumpkin universe is concerned, he's already the nominee. This literally and legitimately made me angry today when I found out that Donald Trump was like, yep, I'm not doing any more debates. I don't need to do any more debates. Really? Okay, so when did you get to that magic number again? Did I miss the memo? Was there some magic election last night, you know, from Timbuktu, I'm not going to use some of the names that folks have been using on Twitter, that has suddenly given you an extra 600 and some odd delegates that nobody knew about? You know, did I miss the memo? Because here's the thing. You agreed to do this. You have now ducked out of now two debates. And you left the folks at CPAC high and dry. Now, let me tell you why this bothers me. As someone who runs a business and who has run a business, if I take the time to review your application and ask you to come in for an interview, and sometimes it takes multiple interviews depending on the business as to whether or not you're going to hire someone, and you blow off the interview, but then you call me back next week and say, hey, yeah, this is Mr. Joe Schmo, you know, I was supposed to interview with you that for that there position there last week, but, you know, I had this car trouble. And my girlfriend, she's really, really pregnant, and we kind of thought that she was going to have that there baby. So I was at the ER up until like 6 o'clock, and then I had to go home and shower, and then I fell asleep in the shower.
and I woke up at like 1 o'clock in the afternoon, and I was like, ah, shoot, I'm supposed to be at that there interview at 12:30. So no, I didn't call you or nothing, but I'm just checking back now, and be like, trying to be all responsible, like, and be like, hey, do you still think you want to give me that job? Come on, you know, I need the job. Come on, I just told you we was about to have a baby. Come on, I need that job. Okay, so I'm embellishing a lot, but it's because I'm angry. But that's exactly what he's doing now to the American public. And those of you that are just standing up and cheering the guy that's basically saying, yeah, we don't need to debate anything anymore because I'm going to go take out Hillary and it's going to be great and it's going to be huge. You're deluding yourself. He's using, I keep trying to think of the word. I heard somebody use it earlier today and I can't think of it now. But prevent offense is basically doing nothing but playing it safe right now. Because it's gotten to the point now where there's not a distraction anymore. Donald Trump doesn't have the yapping, ankle-biting niblet patrol trying to get everybody else's attention on that stage. It was going to be him and Kasich and Cruz. Kasich's dad was a mailman. It's the only thing we know about Kasich, because it's the only thing he tells us over and over and over again. My dad was a mailman. My dad was a civil servant. I've done this. I've done that. I was a good governor. I only created 40,000 jobs, but no, actually, I think he said 400 jobs when he made the mistake, because it was supposed to be 400,000 jobs, but he only said 400. And look, here's the thing with Kasich. Kasich's an okay guy, I guess. I mean, he ran Ohio pretty well. He's got a pretty big albatross hung around his neck with the fact that he decided to use Medicare and Medicaid to expand Obamacare in his state. Whatever. I mean, that was his decision to make. But that's the thing. Look at it from this perspective. Two of the supposed frontrunners, now that Kasich has just decided he's going to be the little dog that's following around the big dogs going, where are we going, Spike? What are we doing, Spike? What are we doing, Spike? Where are we going, Spike? What are we doing, Spike? Where are we going, Spike? Hey, Spike's not answering me. Hey, you, where are we going? What are we doing? Where are we going? What are we doing? Where are we going? What are we doing? You know, now that he's decided he's going to be that little dog, you might as well count him with one of the frontrunners, because apparently they're just going to let him hang on for as long as he needs to do whatever damage he's going to do. But now that he's decided to be that guy, he's going to have to explain why it is that he thought that expanding Obamacare in his home state was a good idea. But look at it from this perspective. Now we have two front runners that are both for socialized medicine, whether they want to admit it or not. We have the shouldn't be a front runner who won't let go. And then we have the actual front runner, who basically told the entire world in a 60 Minutes interview that as far as he was concerned, the government should be paying for health care. And this is the guy that's running for the nomination for the president of the United States for what used to be the conservative party of this country. I don't know how else to say it to you, folks. The Republican Party's done. They had their time, they had their shot, and they're done. They have become so self-absorbed and so concerned with trying to bring as many people into the fold as they could, they forgot the reason they existed in the first place. It's no different. I mean, look at it this way. Think of it this way. You run a restaurant, but there's only about four or five things that you know your chef can cook well. After a while, people start getting tired of those four or five things. So you start adding all of these new things to the menu that make it look big and exciting because you can open it up and there's 18 pages of food in what used to be a two-page menu. And for a couple of months, it's great because everybody's coming in, they're checking out the food. Then they're realizing it sucks, and then they tell their friends it sucks, and then they just stop coming in, and then their friends stop coming in. And then you've got some guy named Gordon Ramsay who comes and bails out your restaurant, who looks at your menu and says, hey, why are there 18 pages of food? And why is half the food that I just ate, why did it taste frozen? Well, because it is frozen, because we have 18 pages of food. when you start trying to accommodate everyone, you lose the ability to accommodate anyone. That's how this works. It's how it's always worked. It's how it's always going to work. And it really is about that simple. When you start trying to make your group large enough that you attempt to accommodate anyone and everyone, you lose the ability to accommodate people at all. Because at some point, you start having to listen to the minorities. And it's the same thing I've been going over and over and over and around and around and around with a friend of mine who happens to be a libertarian. He also happens to be the head of the Libertarian Party in the state that I live in, which is Oklahoma. But at this point, he's gone from being basically more of a... I mean, at some point, I guess he was a conservative. Then he swung a little more libertarian. Then he went anarcho-capitalist. Now he's pretty much full-on anarchist. And the one thing that I keep trying to explain to everybody that thinks that that's the way that we need to go, because that's all I've... So all I've heard in messages and everything, well, if the Republican Party's going to do it this way, maybe you should just become a libertarian. I would love to, except all of you are anarchists. And I said all in the collective sense. I'm not saying that every single libertarian is an anarchist, but almost all of you that I've talked to are anarchists. Look. The thing with anarchy, and I understand it's kind of like socialism. It looks like this really great idea on paper, and maybe it even works well in small groups. But anarchy as a whole, not going to work. And let me tell you why it's not going to work. Human nature. And I know you're thinking, well, what does that have to do with anything? Well, let me tell you. The simple fact of the matter is, whether anybody wants to admit it or not, there are always going to be leaders and there are always going to be followers. So I've told you time and time again on this show, as far as I'm concerned, there are three ways to categorize most of the American people. You have your sheep, which are basically just looking for somebody to tell them where to go. You have the wolves, which are the folks that prey on the sheep, which most of our politicians are now, by the way. And then you have the sheepdogs. The sheepdogs are the folks that usually wind up going into careers like fire, IMSA, PD, military. Those are the people that try to look out for other people. And that's just basically a really quick, easy way to break down the populace. Is it simplistic? Yes, but it works. So again, we have sheepdogs, and wolves. Which one do you think Donald Trump is? I'm telling you right now, he's definitely not a sheep. I also don't think he's a sheepdog. And this is what concerns me. He's not going to be looking out for you and me. No matter what he tells you, that's not what he's going to do. Not what he's here to do. It's not what's going to happen. And it really is just about that simple. He's not going to be looking out for you and me. He's going to be looking out for himself. Look at it this way, and I've said it before, I'll say it again. He has been contemplating and even attempted running for president off and on since 1988 and failed almost every single time he's tried, until now. Again, jury's still out as to whether or not he will, but we'll see. At this point, it's looking more like he'll at least become the nominee, whether anybody wants him to be or not, because the problem is we have lots of people that want him to be. But this is the same guy who keeps telling everybody, I'm not a politician, I'm not a politician, I'm not a politician, I've never been a politician, I don't want to be a politician, I'm just doing this because I love America. So let me tell you the most logical reason as to why Donald Trump is doing this. This is the one aspect of power he's never been able to touch. His name gave him influence before he had the money. The money that he got from his father before his father's death and after solidified the influence that he had from his name, but there were still things that he was not able to do. This will take care of that for him. Not only that, but look at this from another perspective. For the last 8 years, we have had one of the most egomaniacal, potentially sociopathic people ever known to be in the White House. The only thing that's kept it from being a unmitigated disaster instead of a disaster is the fact that he's so naive, he doesn't really know how to use the power that he's had access to. He doesn't know how to wield it. Donald Trump is the anti-Obama. And the reason I call him the anti-Obama is because he has the exact same ego, the exact same narcissistic tendencies, and is most likely a sociopath. I don't know anyone who can say, if she wasn't my daughter, I'd do her, and not be a sociopath. Because that's not something that a normal person says. To be able to do that, you have to lack emotion. I mean, I'm not going to look at my daughter and go, oh yeah, I would so do her if she wasn't my daughter. Because she's hot. And no, he didn't say it exactly that way. But he said it close enough. It was enough to make my skin crawl when I heard it. And that is, again, not something that a normal person says. So we're about to go from one narcissistic, egomaniacal sociopath that didn't know what to do with the power that he had handed to him, to an egomaniacal, narcissistic sociopath who has every inclination of what he plans to do with the power that he's about to have handed to him, because he's been chasing it since 1988. So I ask, the title of the show, and I hadn't gotten there yet, is What Happened to My Party? Because we used to be the conservative party. Now we're the we want to beat the crap out of anybody that doesn't want to agree with us party, and we don't care what it takes for us to win. So when we get back here in just a minute, because we do have to pay some bills, we will actually discuss what I think has happened to the party, and I will be right back with you here in just a couple minutes, right here on WNJC 1360 AM out of Philadelphia. This is Rick Robinson. You are listening to America Off the Rails. And I'll be back with you here in just a couple minutes, so don't go away. All right, folks, this is Rick Robinson with you. I want to tell you about some friends of mine from a company called Security Enforcement Specialists. When I ran my security agency for 12 years, I worked with one of these partners on a daily basis. He's been involved in this agency now, and with his other partner, they do have over 30 years of experience in the private security industry. If you own a business and you need someone to keep you or your customers or residents safe, then I highly recommend contacting Security Enforcement Specialists today. Give them a call at 405-703-1796. Again, that's 405-703-1796. Again, tell them Rick from K98 Talk sent you. Like I said, if you need the help, they are here for you. So make sure that you go look them up, check them out, and see what they can do. The wrong way. Welcome to the place.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
We will never fully understand what we've asked of our military service members or their families, asking them to put themselves in harm's way, to endure it all. But we do understand that it's our turn, our duty, to keep them secure for the rest of their lives. Wounded Warrior Project long-term support programs help our most severely ill or injured veterans live independently, at no cost, for life, so that they might stand at ease. Join us at findwwp.org.
Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the Internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Folks, you are listening to America Off the Rails, now a proud member of the Conservative Commando Radio Network, right here on WNJC 1360 AM, the powerhouse of Philadelphia. Now, I have a question for you. Do you ever find yourself maybe not near a radio? Maybe you're traveling and you don't have access to the internet? Did you know that the Conservatives Commando Radio Network can now be heard on a telephone network by calling 832-999-1199 anytime, day or night? That's right. You can hear every show as it's broadcast live, even if you're not near the radio or an internet, because, who, you know, everybody nowadays has a phone in their hand. But here's the good news, though. As soon as we go off the air at night on the Conservative Commando Radio Network right here on WNJC, you can listen to every show that aired for that day as many times as you want just by dialing that number. It'll be a live feature every day at 12 p.m. daily, and it'll be exclusively for the shows that run on that network. But until the next day when it goes live again, they're going to run them over and over and over again. So now you have on-demand access to the Conservative Commando Radio Network right on your phone. How cool is that? Just remember, the Conservative Commando Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
If you want to work until you keel over, have less of everything in retirement, or give back more of your hard-earned money to the stock market again, then just ignore me. But if you'd like to protect the money you save, receive a steady, predictable retirement income, and enjoy financial security for as long as you live, then listen to this. You can download a free report that reveals the wealth-building secrets Wall Street and the banks don't want you to know. You'll learn how you can get guaranteed growth, safety, and real prosperity without risking your money in the Wall Street casino, and how to get the money you need when you need it, simply by asking for it. This is the best way to have a 100% secure retirement and know your money will last as long as you do. To learn more about this method and to get your free report, go to 29security.com. That's the number 29security.com. 29security.com. Go to 29security.com.
The staff of K98 Talk and the Spark Radio Network is proud to announce that our very own Rowdy Rick Robinson has been selected as one of the top conservative talk show hosts in the nation for his program, America Off the Rails. Again, congratulations to Rowdy Rick Robinson for a job well done and another reason to stay connected to K98 Talk and the Spark Radio Network.
Calls. We got a pen and telephone to bypass all your laws. Political correctness will replace the Bill of Rights. Support religious freedom, bless you, pray to Jesus Christ. The press is in our pockets, cause there's no longer free. You cannot make a move, now that the NSA can see. Don't expect equality, respect for fair play. The IRS will target those who vote the wrong way. Welcome to the
All right, folks, we are back. We are live. This is America Off the Rails. I'm your host, Rick Robinson. You are listening to the show on WNJC 1360 AM out of Philadelphia. It is about 20 minutes past the hour, or 40 minutes past the hour, so we actually did take the break a little long. So at this point, we are down to about 20 minutes-ish till it's about time for me to make my way out of here. Before we get too far, I want to do something I haven't really done in a while. As a reminder, I am part of a network. You may have heard the little bumper there. Not only, pardon me. Not only are we part of the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, but we also have a network of our own, the Spark Radio Network. It's actually probably about to be rebranded. We've just launched a new blog. You can actually find one of the first articles I've put out in a while over there. Don't hold the punctuation against me. I've gotten pretty rusty. I'm working on getting that cleaned back up, but I haven't really written anything in, it's been almost 6 months because I've been so busy doing everything else. But you can find that at sparkofliberty.com. It actually, by the time it's all said and done, will be a web magazine. It will also be the host page of our network, the Spark Radio Network. And also, at some point, we are going to start moving into video broadcasting. For those of you who follow me on Twitter, you've seen my face, and you will probably understand that I will not
probably ever be a part of the in front of the camera crew for the TV portion, but I do enjoy radio and I have a face made for it, so what can I say? All right, so that little bit of a tidbit. Also, part of the network that I run, there are two other shows that are affiliated with that network that you can also hear here. Office Hours with Dr. Arrington with co-host Lou Esposito is on Tuesdays at 5 Eastern, I believe, right in the middle of drive time. And then tomorrow you can hear JD and Stacy with Game On right here on WNJC 1360 AM out of Philadelphia, also 5 o'clock drive time. So basically, if we could figure out a way to get at least one more show on here, because I've got another one I really, really want to get over here, then basically you could probably hear something from us on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. That would be pretty cool. I mean, at some point, I'd like to get it to be like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, but, you know, we'll do what we can, piece at a time, to bring you more and more content over here in Philly, and try to bring you the best that we can. Now, I apologize, actually, while I've been doing the show, my voice has continued to get worse and worse, so I am going to tough it out. I mean, I only get to spend about an hour a week with you guys, and I love being over here, so I'm not going to bail on you early, because, well, honestly, Rick Trader would probably kill me. But the good news is we are about out of time, so I think I can muddle through for a few more minutes. Now, back to what we were talking about before the break, because here's the thing that I keep being confronted with over and over and over again, and that is, if I refuse to vote for Trump, then I'm voting for Hillary. Look, I've already done my part in the primary, folks. I live in the reddest of reddest states possible. In this last election, we have 77 counties in my state. 77 of them. None of them went to Obama. So let me tell you, I did my duty. I voted in the primary. I voted for the guy that I want to get the nod, and I'm not sure if he's going to get it, but I did it anyway. So it doesn't matter at this point. I could write in Mickey Mouse at the top of my ballot. It would void my ballot, so it would never get counted because we don't do write-ins in my state. But all 77 counties are probably still going to go red. So some of you who keep saying over and over again that when you don't vote for Donald Trump, if he gets to be the nominee for the general, then you're automatically voting for Hillary. That's not true. You have to understand how the Electoral College works. Now, for the folks that live in purple states, yeah, if you want to make sure that whoever gets the nomination, that by the time it's all said and done, the White House is supposedly red, then you'll want to go ahead and vote for Trump. But let me tell you why I can't do it in pretty simple terms. Let's say, for the sake of argument, that it does get to be Hillary versus Trump. So basically what you're telling me is, in that instance, I basically get to choose Hillary in a pantsuit or Hillary in a suit and tie, because there really is no difference between the two of them. Now, I know, because I'm in several groups with people all day long that tell me, but Rick, she's evil. She's the true incarnate of evil. There's no way she should ever be able to deserve to be president, and I agree with all of those things. But again, we get the election we deserve. And at this point, what the American people are telling us is we deserve to get to choose between, again, the lesser of two evils. And I'm not sure which of those two is honestly the lesser of the two evils. Because there are things about Donald Trump that I know the media has in their back pocket. And they're just waiting to be able to use them. I mean, why wouldn't they? They don't want him to be president either. And we're about to hand them the easiest target to destroy. There are so many things that he's done in behind closed doors. And there's no way at this point that the media doesn't at least know about some of them. I mean, he's been married how many times? So how many times has he cheated on his wives? He's filed for bankruptcy. He's touting his business acumen when, if you look at his spreadsheets, he tells everybody that he's funding his own campaigns and he's not beholden to anyone. But I've seen a few bank statements that would say otherwise.
At some point, at least from what I've been able to determine, at one point or another, he took money from George Soros. He may or may not have defaulted on that money based on information that I was able to find. But at some point during his lifetime, he has been around the same people that he now claims to be fighting against. And again, as a reminder, he's filed bankruptcy 4 times. He uses the tax code in ways that he knows how to use it to make sure that it benefits him. So if you honestly think that Donald Trump is going to allow the changes that everyone is talking about that they want to actually happen, then you're not paying attention. Because he knows how to work the system, and the system works for him, and he doesn't care about you. You guys listen to everything that he tells you and that he spoon-feeds you, and you listen to him and you lap it up and you're like, oh yay, Donald Trump loves us, he's going to save America, he's going to make America great again. You are doing the exact same thing, that you made fun of Obama supporters for doing for the last 8 years. The man is telling you, word for word, line for line, what he's going to do. And all you're hearing is, make America great again, going to be huge. Going to be huge. Going to build a wall. Going to be huge. Going to be huge. Going to build a wall. Going to build a wall. Got to build a wall. Come on. We can't have immigration bad. Got. Okay, look. I get it. I understand. I do. John McCain won an election because he promised to finish a fence. Then he didn't finish the fence. Barack Obama is about to win an election by promising to build a wall. But then he's not going to build the wall. I mean, come on, guys. Have you forgotten that the New York Times has him off the record basically telling them, yeah, don't pay attention to anything I'm saying right now. These are the American people. They're stupid. I'm just telling them what they need to hear to make sure that I get to the White House. And then everything's going to go right back to the left where it belongs. Donald Trump is left of center. Donald Trump is left of center. Donald Trump is left of center. Yes, at this point I'm repeating myself because I want to make sure that you're understanding. Donald Trump is left of center. We are about to put a leftist in the White House under the Republican label. Now, here is the thing that is important to think about with that. He is a nationalist. He is a populist. If he gets the nomination and he gets the election, the Republican Party will have permanently, for the next several generations, shifted to a populist nationalist movement, because it's the only way that they're going to be able to continue to get elected, is to be more bombastic than the last guy, more crowd-pleasing than the last guy. I mean, for God's sake, after the way this election cycle has been, in 4 years, we might as well just start just calling ourselves the WWE. There might as well just be a ring. And everybody just goes at it. I mean, just do it Royal Rumble style till there's nobody left standing, and then that's our guy. I mean, if we're going to go back to freaking caveman stuff, because that's basically where we are now at this point, is the modern day equivalent of last man standing wins. We might as well go back to actually last man standing wins. I mean, I don't understand, folks. I don't understand all of you that are sitting there saying that Donald Trump has to be the guy that gets the vote. You've seen the things that he's done. You've seen the things that he said, and you're telling me that you want this man to have even more power? Going back to what we were talking about earlier, he is the anti-Obama. He has the exact same attitude, the exact same mindset, the exact same ideas, but the difference is he knows how to use the power well enough to make him dangerous. It's why he's been chasing it since 1988. This was the one thing that his money couldn't buy him. And now he's using his money to buy it. Let that sink in. This was the one thing that his money has up until now not been able to buy him. And you want to understand why he's self-funding. It's because this is to prove something to him. His money will have bought him the presidency by the time it's all said and done. He knows it, I know it, and now you know it. Because that's how he thinks.
And if you don't believe me, just pay a lot more attention to what he's saying. The best indication of future behavior is past behavior. Go back. It's all there. They've put a lot of it on YouTube. The things that he said, the things that he's done, the things that have changed. And the one recurring theme over and over and over again is at some point along the way, he got it in his head that he wanted to be president, but he couldn't find a way to make it happen until now. In 1988, we were smart enough that he didn't even try. He thought about it. I think he might have even filed, but he didn't try. A few years later, he changed party affiliation and tried and ran actually a primary, I think, or something in California. Got several votes, decided not to do it. Toyed with the idea several times since then. Each time has decided not to do it or not to carry through with it until now. He has been chasing this idea since 1988. And you tell me that he's not a politician. He has been working on this behind the scenes since 1988. Even when he wasn't doing so publicly, he was doing so privately. Why do you think he's been handing out all of this money? If you think it was just because he could get better backroom deals when it came to his businesses, you're not paying attention to how the man operates. He has been laying the groundwork to do this for almost three decades. And we are buying into it hook, line, and sinker. And I say we in the collective sense because a lot of us are sitting back here kicking and screaming. I mean, it's like watching a train going out of control. And you're one of the only people that knows that the train is going out of control. So you're at the front of the thing trying to bust your way in to get control of it. And the guy that's actually at the wheel is just sitting back there laughing, going, yeah, no, it's all right. I got this. While we're all going to heck. Exactly what I feel like right now. It's the same thing that I've said over and over again. It seems to me there's some delicious irony in the fact that 5 years ago, I started a show called America Off the Rails. And these... I almost said something I shouldn't. And these Trump supporters are going around calling themselves the Trump Train. Telling you this right now, the Trump Train will be what finishes taking America off the rails. We are watching the destruction of this nation. May not happen today. May not happen tomorrow. But it's going to happen. And at this point, it doesn't matter whether Hillary gets the nod or Trump gets the nod. Because here's the problem, and it's something that I've told you about time and time and time again. It doesn't matter anymore whether they're Democrat or Republican. What matters is they all want the same things. They all want control. They all want to find a way to consolidate their control. They just up until now have had varying degrees of how quickly they want to get us there. The Democratic Party has been trying to use the equivalent of a Japanese bullet train. Anytime they're in power, they get as many changes rammed through as quickly as they can. Then the American people notice and they put the Conservative Party, air quotes, back in power, and then they start putting the brakes on things, but they're still quietly and secretly been doing the same things that the Democratic Party has been doing. They're just doing it in a slow enough way that maybe, hopefully, you won't notice, because they all basically want the same thing. They want their power consolidated. And this is why the American public is so enthralled with Trump, because he's telling them what they need to hear. Because they're starting to understand how the system works, why the system works the way it does, and he's telling you he's going to break it apart. He's going to change it. He's going to make it fair for you. He's going to make it back the way it should be. He's going to make America great again. Except he doesn't intend on doing any of those things. What he intends to do is the same thing that all of them pretty much intend to do, other than possibly Cruz, because he's the one guy in recent history that said, I'm going to go to Washington and I'm going to do this. And he did it. It was basically the 21st century equivalent to Mr. Smith goes to Washington. That was Cruz. And yet he's being frozen out. He's being frozen out so badly that he came in last place in D.C. Donald Trump, while he came in third place in D.C., was still more preferable to the folks that are living in D.C. than Cruz.
That speaks volumes about that man, if you ask me. If you're going to come in last place in a city that you work in all day, every day, it's got to be proof that you're not doing something that makes folks happy. And the folks in D.C. are pretty much the last ones that I want to see happy. I'm just saying. So as we come to a close, I have to ask this question again, and I'm only asking this so that you can answer it for yourself. I don't need to know the answer, don't want to know the answer. Who is it that you're going to vote for? Have you made your mind up yet? Do you know which of the people that you're going to be holding the lever for? Whether you're Democrat or Republican, do you know who it's going to be? You don't have to tell me. You don't have to justify it to me. I'm not trying to change your mind. I'm just trying to make you think. I will be the first one to tell you that I will not vote for Trump. I cannot vote for Trump. And one of the biggest turning points for me was watching him on a national stage make fun of someone with a congenital birth defect when I myself have two special needs children. This is not the person that we need to have running the White House. The Republican nominee and the Democratic nominee are supposed to epitomize the best of both parties. If Donald Trump is now the standard bearer for the Republican Party, then the Republican Party and I no longer see eye to eye. And with that note, I tell you again, when I leave the Republican Party, because I'm on my way out the door, it will not be I that left the Republican Party. I didn't leave them. They left me. They left me when they kept trying to make everything so big tent that they stopped caring about their base. When they started trying to make everything so big tent that it became impossible to deal with anyone because you're trying to include everyone. But again, folks, as I say every show, I don't care if you agree with me 90% of the time or 9% of the time. Put down the remote, get off the couch, and find a way to get involved, because you as an American are the only one that can save your country. I can't do it by myself, but I'm going to stand up here swinging for the fences until we make something happen or until it all goes away. Until I talk to you again, folks, have a great rest of your week. Be back with you next week. Philly, don't go away.
Game over, man. It's game over.
If you want to work until you keel over, have less of everything in retirement, or give back more of your hard-earned money to the stock market again, then just ignore me. But if you'd like to protect the money you save, receive a steady, predictable retirement income, and enjoy financial security for as long as you live, then listen to this. You can download a free report that reveals the wealth-building secrets Wall Street and the banks don't want you to know. You'll learn how you can get guaranteed growth, safety, and real prosperity without risking your money in the Wall Street casino, and how to get the money you need when you need it, simply by asking for it. This is the best way to have a 100% secure retirement and know your money will last as long as you do. To learn more about this method and to get your free report, go to 29security.com. That's the number 29security.com. 29security.com. Go to 29security.com.